Continuing coverage now, we're learning more about the fatal plane crash that took place Sunday night outside the Medford Airport at the Airport Chevrolet dealership. Now the National Transportation Safety Board is conducting a thorough investigation to find out what may have led to that crash. We learned yesterday that the plane crash resulted in the death of two people, the pilot, 69-year-old Donald Sefton, and his passenger, 67-year-old Valerie Serpa. Now both Sefton and Serpa were from Fallon, Nevada. That was where the plane was heading. The plane was registered in Sefton's name. It was a 1977 Piper PA-31-350. It crashed shortly after taking off from the Rogue Valley Metric International Airport. Shortly after the takeoff, the plane nosedived right into the parking lot of the Airport Chevrolet dealership. News Watch 12's Daniel Ramirez is live at the scene as we continue to provide more information as we get that. Daniel, what's the latest on that investigation?
Yeah, Brian, we find ourselves here on Chevy Way, which earlier today was the last of three streets that have since been reopened by the city of Medford following Sunday's tragic incident just behind us here at Airport Chevrolet along Biddle Road. Now, just a few hours ago, Brian, as you mentioned earlier today, we had a chance to speak with NTSB's lead investigator. And just off the top, she told us that yesterday they worked on removing the bodies of the two passengers on board the Piper PA-31 from the scene. And as for today, they've been working through the aircraft and documenting the ground scars from the impact of the plane over the pavement surface of the dealership parking lot, along with being able to salvage any information from any debris remains that weren't engulfed by the flames. Right now, she tells us that they are in a fact-finding phase, which consists of documenting everything and trying to determine what they can actually be able to get any meaningful data from. So even if they do see something that might have potential information or a data point, it is not analyzed until later on once they're able to conclude looking for everything. But for now, that is all they're trying to recover, what they can find and what they have. And she says that the preliminary report on their ongoing investigation should be set in about 2 weeks. Meanwhile, the final report can vary in a time frame of up to 2 years, depending on the findings throughout, that including what they are able to pick up on based off findings, anomalies, any failures that are still trying to determine, and any motives behind them. And throughout our afternoon shows, we'll continue to provide you with more updates regarding our conversation with the lead investigator on behalf of NTSB across our shows at Newswatch 12, 5, and 6. But for now, reporting from Airport Chevrolet, Newswatch 12's Daniel Ramirez. Back to you, Brian, in the studio.
Local agencies working with the FAA and the NTSB have directed Newswatch 12 to speak with the Medford Police Department, and we're able to get in touch with them today to get a better understanding of their role when it comes to plane crashes. On Newswatch 12 at midday today, our reporters were there to cover that Chevy Way and Biddle Road had reopened to traffic. Newswatch 12 asked Lieutenant Boudreau if the department was prepared to handle the situation. He tells us not only are plane crash response protocols outlined for officers, but the department has also had experience with a plane crash in the past.
It's a very rare event. It has happened twice now in at least the last 30 years, and that's pretty good considering that we are right by a very busy airport.
He says the response to a plane crash really depends on how many people are involved, the types of structures that are threatened, and how large the aircraft is. He says the main goal of the FAA and the NTSB has been to preserve life and preserve the scene. MPD has been able to help the agencies in preserving the scene by monitoring the area of the crash and ensuring the scene is not disturbed by any outsiders. On Newswatch 12 at 5 tonight, we'll give you more information about MPD's role in that crash situation.